It's January 15th, 1998. A group of aspiring comedians are in a room hoping to audition for a TV show. After introducing themselves, they pull a ticket out of a raffle box. Out of all the people there, only one person got the winning ticket, and he was quickly whisked away. He doesn't know what he signed up for. All he knows is that this might be his big break. For the next 15 months, 22-year-old Tomoaki Hamatsu, stage named Nasubi due to his eggplant-shaped head, will endure the most painful and isolating torture for the enjoyment of Japan. This is the price of fame, Nasubi's story. Before we begin, I have to give some backstory for this show. The show was called Susanoo Denpa Shonen. It was a reality show that aired on Japan's Nippon TV. The show was infamous for having contestants participate in crazy and downright abusive challenges. For example, one challenge had a Japanese comedian and a Hong Kong radio DJ hitchhike from South Africa to Norway. Neither of them knew each other's languages, and they were not allowed to spend any money. They constantly faced hunger and dehydration. At one point, the two had to cross the Sahara Desert, and due to the harsh weather, the Japanese comedian collapsed and had to be airlifted to the hospital. Another challenge saw a group of contestants stay in a single room with only a TV, and their faces were blurred. The challenge was to test their loyalty for their favorite baseball teams. If their team won, they ate, and a small portion of their faces would be unblurred. But if their team lost, they wouldn't eat, and the lights would be turned off until the next day's game. A lot of the contestants were aspiring comedians, and they hoped that being on this show would help them become famous. Back to Nasubi. After being led into a car, Nasubi was blindfolded and taken to his destination. Upon removing the blindfold, he found himself in a small apartment. This apartment had the essentials like electricity, running water, and a bathroom. But there was no food, no bed, and strangest of all, there was a large rack of magazines. Toshio Tsuchiya, the show's producer, then demanded Nasubi to take off his clothes. He was of course confused but complied. He gave Nasubi a camera and microphone and told him the footage collected would probably be aired on TV one day. Afterwards, he and the production crew left Nasubi in the apartment. Nasubi was challenged to win 1 million yen worth of prizes for magazine sweepstakes. Keep in mind, Nasubi had nothing on him. No food, no clothes, no toiletries. So everything he needed had to be won from these sweepstakes. For the first 2 weeks, he only lived off of water, but he eventually won his first item and meal, a case of fiber jelly. Next, he won a 5-pound bag of rice, which became his main diet. He couldn't cook the rice, so he ate it raw, which he didn't like. He almost gave up before finding a solution, by using an empty fiber jelly can as a makeshift pot. Every day was the same for Nasubi. He woke up, filled in sweepstake forms, and waited for a knock on the door. Whenever he did win something, he was ecstatic, and he would do a little dance with his prize. I should also mention that whenever he heard a knock on the door, he had to cover himself using a pillow. I'm surprised none of the delivery men asked him what he was doing. They probably thought he was into some kinky stuff. A lot of the things he won were pretty useless. He won a bike, but he could only use it inside the apartment. He also won a TV, but it only showed static. Despite all of this, winning these things meant he was one step closer to his goal. He was sure that when all this was over, his journey would be broadcasted, and he would finally be famous. Except, that's not what happened. Denpa Shonen was airing his journey, and he already became a celebrity. He just didn't know. Every Sunday, Denpa Shonen would show Nasubi's segment titled A Life of Prizes. Each segment showed a list of all the things he entered that month, what prizes he won, and how much he had left in his goal. These segments were portrayed to be lighthearted with a hyped-up announcer and colorful text appearing on screen. My favorite scenes are his diary scenes. Basically, whenever something bad or good happened, a passage from his diary would appear, and a woman's voice would read so innocently while piano music played in the background. Like, wow, I'm out of rice and now I have to resort to eating dog food? Isn't that so funny? The ratings for these segments were superb for the show, with around 17 million people watching concurrently. To keep up with the popularity, Nasubi was now being live-streamed 24/7 on the internet. Don't worry, no one saw his cock and balls because there were moderators actively censoring them. Nasubi had become a well-known celebrity at this point, and the production crew had to move him to a new apartment because fans and the media figured out where he was living. While doing research, there were times when I questioned whether or not Tsuchiya the producer had any involvement in Nasubi's progress. For example, during the first few days, Nasubi heard a knock on the door. It was a delivery person with a bowl of ramen. He asked Nasubi if he was at the right apartment. Nasubi said no and the man left. Why would the delivery man ask that question? I mean, don't Japanese apartments have numbers on the doors? Another example would be some of the prizes Nasubi won. He won 4 tires, a PlayStation, and a live spiny lobster, yet he never won a useful piece of clothing. The only clothes he won were a pair of small panties, formal shoes, a belt, and a pair of Adidas shoes. I should also mention that years before the challenge, Denpa Shonen was in hot water for helping a contestant cheat. This contestant had to hitchhike across Eurasia, and the producers had him flown from place to place instead. Now, if what I said sounds like torture to you, get ready for this. Even though Nasubi had to go through these hardships, he could leave at any time. He wasn't locked in, no one was stopping him, it was his choice to be here, but he decided to stay and finish what he started. Remember, he was a struggling comedian who wanted to break into the entertainment industry. Perhaps he thought that once he left that apartment, he would be leaving his dreams behind. He would be back home, empty-handed, and to a father who never wanted him to become a comedian in the first place. Or maybe he didn't want to end up on a registry. By December 1998, Nasubi had finally reached his goal, and as a reward, he was taken to South Korea, where he was finally given clothes, he ate real food, and he had fun at an amusement park. But the real fun didn't start until later that night. Nasubi was blindfolded and taken again. When he was told to take off the blindfold, he found himself in another apartment, much like the one he had been previously in. Yep, Nasubi had to repeat the challenge all over again. Except this time, his goal was to win enough money for an economy plane ticket back to Japan. Same rules as before, but he now had to raise 46,900 yen, and these magazines were in Korean, a language he didn't know. Luckily, he was given a Korean to Japanese dictionary. Tsuchiya told him he didn't have to go on with this, but he wanted to continue. By this time, Nasubi was an expert at these sweepstakes, and he managed to knock out his goal in a matter of weeks. Tsuchiya wanted to keep him as long as possible to keep these ratings up, so he changed the goal without telling Nasubi. On the show, the announcer justified the change by saying that since he worked so hard, he only deserved the best. His new goal was to earn 57,300 yen for a business class ticket. Again, he quickly knocked this out by winning expensive tea leaves. And guess what? Tsuchiya changed his goal again to 81,600 yen for a first class ticket, and he met that goal in a matter of weeks as well. He had spent 3 months in that apartment, and as promised, he was finally sent back to Japan. Upon returning to Japan, Nasubi just wanted to go home and not think any more of this, but the show had something else for him. He was once again blindfolded and taken to a familiar room. He then started to do what he had always been doing for the past 15 months. But then... Nasubi was confused, and then the host told him the truth. Every minute of his life was being broadcast for the entertainment of millions. He was then told about his celebrity status, like how a diary he had been keeping was turned into a bestseller, how other news sources like the BBC had reported on him, and how a ramen company turned a clip of him eating a bowl of their ramen into a popular commercial. Out of everything we covered, there is one scene that always stood out to me. 3 days after he came back to Japan, Nasubi is shown in a hotel room watching himself on Denpa Shonen. When he gets to the scene where his apartment wall has collapsed, he doesn't say that much. What was going through his mind at that moment? Confusion? Relief? Honestly, I don't have a solid answer, but I'll never forget it. Despite seeing all of the colorful text on screen and hearing all the wacky as fuck music, Nasubi went through hell, and the show tried to mask all of this as comedy. Nasubi would talk about this experience in interviews saying, "Everything was harsh and every day was like hell back then. Although I seemed to look like I was having fun, most of the time on the edited show, to me, it was full of pain." So, what happened to Nasubi after Denpa Shonen? Well, he had a tough time getting used to clothes because he was so comfortable being naked, and he was now an introvert, which hurt his comedy career, but he did find a few TV and movie roles here and there. Side note, he was a side character on this superhero show called Kamen Rider. His character was called Watcherman, and he was this otaku blogger who rode around in a bike, that he, get this, won in a sweepstakes. God damn it, man. Despite his career not being as big as he had hoped, he starred in an acting troupe called Eggplant Way and they travel all around Japan. Outside of comedy, he's done a lot of community service for his hometown of Fukushima. In 2016, he climbed Mount Everest to raise funds for the town after the 2011 nuclear disaster. He also has a web series called Nasubi's Question, where he educates viewers on nuclear energy and radiation. During the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, Nasubi would use his experience in isolation to encourage others to stay at home. He also has Twitter if you want to see what he's up to, and he's pretty active on it. I'll link it below. What happened to Denpa Shonen afterwards? Well, the show continued to run until it was canceled in September 2002, thanks to the Japanese government stepping in and canceling torture-themed game shows. But the show did have a revival on the internet in 2009 called Denpa Shonen International. As for Tsuchiya the producer, for a while he said he didn't regret doing what he did to Nasubi. Instead, he justified himself by saying he only captured miracles on film. He did apologize later in life, and the two have reconciled. Nasubi's story should be a cautionary tale. Don't be desperate and don't show any desperation, because you might be taken advantage of and become worse or find little success. Well, that's how I interpret it. I guess another thing you could take from this is reality TV is garbage.